I talked to the kids this morning. And let's just say, if they owe you their lives, they won't blackmail you ever again.
Again? Does that mean
we're married, James. And we do love each other. Even though you are a 6-foot melon half of the time. But you have some serious stuff you have to work on, because there is only so much that I can take.
Thank you. I don't deserve you.
No. You really don't. Come here. This doesn't mean you're forgiven. But this is a pretty good start.
Uh-oh.
You've not forgiven him, have you?
James made a mistake, didn't you? And yous weren't exactly angels. You know, the doghouse yet. But he's going through some stuff right now, so I would appreciate it if you cut me some slack. Especially if you want to go on holiday.
Holiday? We're going on holiday?
Benidorm, baby.
Wait.
I'll take it if we fly first class.
First class to Benidorm? I don't even think you can do... Are we going first class?
I'm not that sorry. No, we need to chat.
You know what? I was going to go pack.
No. Wait. You are not coming. This holiday is for me and your father to get our marriage back on track.
I thought this holiday was to get our family back on track.
After they blackmailed me? You think I'm going to spend a week all-inclusive with Damien? No, the purpose of this holiday is to get as far away from your offspring as possible.
Offspring?
Did you listen to a single word that I said yesterday? You are such a melt.
I think you should find somewhere else to sleep tonight.
But this is my home.
Is it? Well, it's all you're going to have left if you don't put your ideas up.
I want you gone by the time I get back.
Right, I am doing this as a favour for our stay. If I hear you moaning about the noise, the mess, how long people are taking in the shower, then you're out.
Wonderful.
Oh, and you can leave that sarcasm at the door. Tea's at 6, it's chicken dippers. If you don't like that, you can starve.
Why'd you leave the front door open?
Shh. I didn't.
What's that going to do?
Who's there?
Come on, then. Show yourself!
Don't think we're quite there yet.
What are you doing here?
Well, it is my home, remember?
Christmas presents!
So you think you can weasel yourself back in with a few gifts? Oh. Hope you get the receipt. Lucas has already got a top that's similar to that one.
Yeah. This ain't a similar one. This is my one. Are you kicking me out?
I'd like you to think of it more of a little vacation at Auntie Leela's.
No, you're not chucking me son out.
I just think we'll be able to sort out our issues if there's one less complication
around. Lucas, you're sat here now, you can't do that. Have you just called me kid a complication?
Well, he is as far as I'm concerned.
You two, can you go to Leela's, get your tea, pick you up in a bit?
What are you gonna do?
Go! I'm gonna sort this out once and for all. Chucking Lucas out is low, even for you.
Well, I'll take that as a compliment.
You're not even remorseful, are you?
Why should I be?
Because he's a kid, James. What is your problem with him?
It's not Lucas in particular. I'd have a problem with any disruptive or disrespectful teenager. He needs to be taken in hand.
No, I'm not saying that Lucas is a saint by no means. But if anyone is going to discipline me son, it's going to be me, it ain't going to be you.
I've seen your parenting style firsthand. I mean, most of the time you turn a blind eye. And if you do acknowledge it, you then try and bribe them to make it better.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. Oh, let's go to the love boat for some cheesy chips. Oh, let's ignore what just happened and have a love cave marathon. It's a joke.
Well, you're hardly parent of the year yourself, James. Look at your Romeo. He ain't exactly perfect.
This isn't about Romeo and me. This is about you and your son. Okay, Lucas needed a short, sharp shock, and I'm not sorry that I was the one to give it to him.
When did it happen, eh?
When did what happen?
When did you turn into your dad?